Hello everyone, welcome to this channel. Today we are going to study The Old Man at the Bridge, written by Ernest Hemingway. He was an American novelist, short story writer and journalist. The story is based on a true incident that Hemingway had witnessed as a reporter during the Spanish Civil War. The story emphasizes upon the reality that it is the common people who have to suffer the most during a war, in spite of the fact that they are innocent. Before we move forward, a request. Please subscribe to my channel and hit the like button if you find my videos useful. Ernest Miller Hemingway was an American novelist, short story writer, and journalist, whose simple and understated writing was a strong influence on 20th century fiction. So his writing was simple, in fact we should say deceptively simple, because through his simple use of language he conveyed profound ideas which struck a chord in the hearts of the readers. One of the shortest of Ernest Hemingway's short stories, Old Man at the Bridge, is based upon an incident that took place during an Easter Sunday stopover at the Ebro River, while Hemingway was a war correspondent covering the Spanish Civil War. So this incident was something that Hemingway witnessed with his own eyes during an Easter Sunday stopover at the Ebro River in Spain. Old Man at the Bridge demonstrates the power of narrative art. The power of narrative art means the power of narrating an incident or storytelling. Hemingway takes a small ordinary detail in a situation and through the art of storytelling transforms it into a powerful story about the tragedy of war. The old man becomes a symbol of the countless civilian victims of war, those without politics. Without politics means those who do not support or those who are not motivated by any particular political ideology. They are just common people going about their everyday business. The old man is also one of them. Displaced, disoriented, and alone, he is faced with the inevitability of death. So he has been displaced. Why? Because he has had to leave his home and all his belongings, everything. Not only his home, but his hometown. He has had to leave it and he has been asked to go away. He is disoriented because he is not able to come to terms with the world around him. He doesn't know what he is going to do. And he is totally alone. He has no family. He has nobody who can help him. So it is not possible for him to survive. He is an old man and under these conditions, he is so weak that definitely he cannot survive. So he is faced with the inevitability of death. The story in brief. The narrator, a soldier, saw an old man sitting by the side of the road. He had left his home and walked this far, but was too tired to go any further, naturally, because he's an old man. He kept on worrying about his animals. The soldier reassured him and tried to persuade him to move away from the spot, because it was dangerous to stay there. The enemy was advancing and would be there at any moment, and the soldiers also would have had to resort to firing, and there would be a skirmish. So the soldier wanted him to move away. In fact, all the people had been ordered to move away from that place, which is why they were crossing the bridge and they were going to the other side. But the old man could not walk any further. The soldier understood that ultimately the old man, who was in no way connected to the war, would not survive. He would become a casualty of war. After trying to coax the old man for a while, the soldier finally understood that this man is not going to be able to survive, because war is a very, very harsh condition. It's a very demanding situation and the old man does not have the necessary strength to survive. So he is not connected to the war in any way. He is an innocent victim. But we know for sure that he is going to become a casualty of war. An old man with steel-rimmed spectacles and very dusty clothes sat by the side of the road. So the steel-rimmed spectacles emphasize the old man's age. The very dusty clothes emphasize the fact that the old man has walked very far. There was a pontoon bridge across the river. A pontoon bridge is a temporary floating bridge. And carts, trucks, and men, women, and children were crossing it. The mule-drawn carts staggered up the steep bank from the bridge with soldiers helping push against the spokes of the wheels. So for the carts, first of all, they had to cross the bridge. After crossing the bridge, they had to climb up the steep bank. And it was difficult for them. They were staggering up the steep bank because it was because of the steepness, because of the sharp incline. So the soldiers were helping the carts to move by pushing against the wheels. The trucks ground up and away, heading out of it all. So the bank of the river had soft mud, which is why the tires of the trucks, they sunk into it a little bit. So the trucks had to rev up the engine and then accelerate their way out of it. And the peasants plodded along in the ankle-deep dust. So for the ones who were walking, the common people, the common farmers who were walking, it was difficult because as soon as they would put their foot on the ground, their foot would sink into the dust, into the ankle-deep dust. But in spite of that, they kept on walking heavily because it was important for everybody to keep moving. They had to leave that place because the enemy was advancing. But the old man sat there without moving. He was too tired to go any farther. So everyone was moving, but the old man was just not able to move. It was my business to cross the bridge, explore the bridgehead beyond, and find out to what point the enemy had advanced. So the narrator, who is the soldier, he says that I had to cross the bridge again. Then I went to the bridgehead beyond. Now, what is a bridgehead? Bridgehead is an important area which is under the control of this particular army. Okay. And once you go to that area, and that area is so important, you don't want the enemy forces to cross that particular area. Once you go there with your binoculars or whatever equipment you have, you can find out to what point the enemy has advanced. I did this and returned over the bridge. So the narrator, he crossed the bridge, he went to the bridgehead, he tried to find out to what point the enemy had advanced, then he returned over the bridge, he came back. There were not so many carts now and very few people on foot, but the old man was still there. So most of the people had moved away. After all, some time had also passed, but the old man had still not moved, he was still sitting there. "Where do you come from?" I asked him. "From San Carlos," he said and smiled. That was his native town, and so it gave him pleasure to mention it, and he smiled. "I was taking care of animals," he explained. "Oh," I said, not quite understanding. "Yes," he said. "I stayed, you see, taking care of animals. I was the last one to leave the town of San Carlos." He did not look like a shepherd or a herdsman. And I looked at his black dusty clothes and his grey dusty face and his steel-rimmed spectacles and said, "What animals were they?" "Various animals," he said and shook his head. "I had to leave them." So the old man was very disappointed, which is why he shook his head and he said, "I had to leave them. I was forced to leave them. I was the last one to leave this town, the town of San Carlos." That was his native town. That is why he smiled when he mentioned it first to the soldier. And you can see that even without being asked, he gave out this information. He said, "I was taking care of animals." So here we can understand how much he was attached to his animals. And also without speaking, even though he is not saying this, we can understand it is natural for him to be attached to his home, his native town, because his identity is based on that. But suddenly he had to leave. He did not want to leave. He says, "I was the last one to leave." I was watching the bridge and the African-looking country of the Ebro Delta and wondering how long now it would be before we would see the enemy, and listening all the while for the first noises that would signal that ever mysterious event called contact. And the old man still sat there. African looking country of the Ebro Delta means that the area was very green. It was covered with vegetation and the vegetation was really dense. So there was a sense of wilderness, a sense of the wild over there. So in this setting, The soldier, he was performing his duty. He was speaking to the old man. At the same time, he was keeping an eye out for the enemy. He was watching the bridge. He was listening all the while, because when the enemy troops advanced, there would be some noise once they reached a particular area. And that would mean that the enemy had arrived. Okay, so much was happening all around, but the old man still sat there. What animals were they? I asked. There were three animals altogether, he explained. There were two goats and a cat, and then there were four pairs of pigeons. And you had to leave them? I asked. Yes, because of the artillery. The captain told me to go because of the artillery. So the soldier, in spite of the difficult situation, has not lost his humanity, which is why he's making conversation with the old man and trying to coax him into moving. So that is the reason why he asks that what animals are these, because the old man is continuously talking about his animals. So he must be wondering, why is he so attached? That is why he also says, oh, you had to leave them. And now the old man says, I had to leave them because of the artillery. Then it becomes clear that even because of the artillery, probably he would not have left. Why did he leave? Because the captain told him to go. And you have no family? I asked, watching the far end of the bridge where a few less carts were hurrying down the slope of the bank. So now the soldier, he looked at the other end of the bridge where the last few carts, they were also moving away hurriedly. They were also leaving the dangerous situation as quickly as they could. But the old man was all alone and he was still sitting there. So the soldier asked him, you have no family? No, he said, only the animals I stated. The cat, of course, will be all right. A cat can look out for itself, but I cannot think what will become of the others. So he's not worried about the cat, but he's worried about the other animals. What politics have you? I asked. So the soldier is now curious. And so he asks him, what political ideology do you support? Whose side are you on? I am without politics, he said. So the old man replies that I am just a common man going about my everyday business. I do not support any particular ideology. I am not on any particular side. I am 76 years old. I have come 12 kilometers now and I think I can go no further. So through these three sentences, he very powerfully and heart-wrenchingly states his case. The soldier is touched and he's concerned about the old man. So he says, this is not a good place to stop, I said. If you can make it, there are trucks up the road where it forks for Tortosa. So if you can just put in a little bit of an effort and walk a little bit, then you will see after a little while, the road forks. It divides into two and on one side, it goes towards Tortosa. I will wait for a while, he said, and then I will go. Where do the trucks go? So, okay, I'll wait for a while and then I'll go. I'll make an attempt. But where do these trucks go? If I get a lift on one of those trucks, then where will the truck take me? Towards Barcelona, I told him. I know no one in that direction, he said, but thank you very much. Thank you again very much. So here the old man is conveying that even if he does get a lift and he goes towards Barcelona, what will he do over there? He doesn't know, because he doesn't know anyone and he's all alone and helpless. He's very weak because of his age, but still he is grateful to the soldier. He looked at me very blankly and tiredly, then said, having to share his worry with someone, the cat will be all right, I'm sure. There is no need to be unquiet about the cat. But the others? Now, what do you think about the others? So he's not able to get the worry about the animals out of his mind. The soldier replies, why? They'll probably come through it all right. So the soldier is trying to reassure him. You think so? Why not? I said, watching the far bank where now there were no carts. So the soldier is trying to motivate him into moving ahead. So he says, why not? But what will they do under the artillery when I was told to leave because of the artillery? So the old man persists with his questions. He says, but what will my poor animals do when the artillery arrives there? In fact, I was told to leave. The captain told me that I had to leave or I would not survive. So how will my poor animals survive? Did you leave the dove cage unlocked? I asked. Yes, then they'll fly. Yes, certainly they'll fly. But the others, it's better not to think about the others, he said. So he says, yes, the doves will certainly fly because I have left the cage door unlocked. But what will happen to the other animals? The cat will also survive. But what will happen to the others? But then he himself says, I cannot think about them. It is better that I stop thinking about the other animals. If you are rested, I would go, I urged. Get up and try to walk now. Thank you, he said, and got to his feet, swayed from side to side, and then sat down backwards in the dust. So the old man made one last effort. Somehow he got up. He stood on his feet, but he was so tired, he was so exhausted and weak that he could not even stand properly. He swayed from side to side and then he immediately sat down on the ground again. There was nothing to do about him. So now the soldier gave up hope that this man could not be saved. He would definitely die. It was Easter Sunday. That is the irony. Because Easter is the day on which Jesus Christ rose from the dead. So he is the Savior. He rose from the dead. He had come back from the dead. But it is exactly on the same day that the old man's life is in danger. So it was Easter Sunday and the fascists were advancing toward the Ebro. So the enemies were coming closer and closer. So the old man would not be saved, even though it was Easter Sunday. It was a gray, overcast day with a low ceiling, so their planes were not up. The fascists' planes were not up in the sky simply because the sky was thickly clustered with clouds. That is why the planes were not there. Or else by now the planes would have arrived and they would probably have bombed the place. So that was a stroke of good luck. That and the fact that cats know how to look after themselves was all the good luck that the old man would ever have. This means that the old man would not survive the war. The old man would not have any good luck. He would only have two comforts. First, that the sky was overcast and that is why there were no planes in the sky. And the second, that cats know how to look after themselves. The cat can survive. These are the only two things that could comfort the old man for a short period. Let us look at the symbols in the story. The bridge, that is the pontoon bridge, symbolizes uncertainty and danger because it is a temporary arrangement and it is floating. So the ground, or rather the water underneath it, that's very shaky. So it signifies uncertainty and danger. The pigeons symbolize the refugees. The doves symbolize peace and harmony. We note that at first the old man refers to his birds as pigeons, but towards the end, the same reference is changed to doves. When the soldier talks about the birds, he talks about doves, not pigeons. So this is a symbol of the fact that initially, because of the war, naturally there will be many refugees. But with the passage of time, peace and harmony will certainly return. The cat symbolizes the independent person, a person who is ruthless, who is independent, who is street smart, who is tough, and who can survive even in adverse or hostile conditions. The goat symbolizes the old man. The goat is a sacrificial animal. The goat does not harm anybody. But in spite of that, the goat gets sacrificed, just like the old man. He had no politics. He never harmed anybody. He was just a common man living in his native town, in his house, and looking after animals. He was just a harmless old man, yet he was the one who would get sacrificed. He was the one who would be killed in the war. So the overall message of the story is that common people are the innocent victims of war.